What's up, guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I decided to go to Mombasa Old Town, and as you can see already, I love Mombasa. It's a warm welcome here, guys. In Old Town we have some businesses. We have people selling bracelets, we have people selling necklaces. There's quite small businesses that go on here, and you'll see as we go by. So guys, we have the Old Town is not as big, but it's quite interesting because it's where we have the Four Cheeses. And as you can see, the place is cool. No, there's no congestion. And as you can see, guys, is from this first house, the houses are old because they were built very many years ago, and that's why it has the name Old Town. As we proceed, guys, you can see that there is Africa Hotel that was built in 1901. It was the first hotel in Old Town. I'm not sure if it's in Mombasa, the whole of Mombasa, but I know in Old Town it was the first hotel, and apparently it has been made to be the Safina High School, that is this building. Guys, as you continue, you'll notice that there is a white weird building down there. That is the first mosque in Mombasa, and people still use it up to date. People go to worship there because, yeah, it's still a strong building, so it has to be used. Anyway, guys, you notice that most of these houses are either faint white, white that is faded, and this other color, I don't know if it's yellow. I think I'm colorblind, oh my god. But you realize most of the building have the same colors. There is some kind of uniformity, and you realize that it's different from the town, from the ground town. We have blue and white buildings down here, guys. As you can see, there is this building. It's for Othani Hotel. It's a very fancy restaurant that is facing the beach, right on the other face. And I didn't get time to go here, but next time, guys, when I'm going to do the For Jesus vlog, I'll make sure I come down here. On this wall, guys, we have the port. It's among the first ports in Mombasa, the oldest actually, and we have another branch in Changamwe. As we proceed, guys, you realize that we have very old houses, very old. Even this place surrounded by iron is a building that collapsed, and they have to rebuild it because it can't just be wasted space. Any of the buildings are old to an extent that they are collapsing. Oh my god, they must be very, very old. But as we proceed, guys, you'll notice that there's a building that is kind of attractive for me because I didn't come across such a building any area of this kind. And guys, here we have a coffee house. It used to operate as a coffee house alone, but nowadays they offer biryani, they offer some food like pilau and so on, guys. For me, it's a cool place. There is no noise, there is no... I love the place, but actually, it's very unsafe, guys. I'll tell you why at the end of this video. Then this house, as my tour guide told me, it used to be a church for Christians, of course. And apparently, as you can see, it's written Old Portuguese Church, but apparently it's not a church. It's no longer used as a church. You notice that there are other shops selling arts, selling some clothes like deras, selling earrings, and this is a place where they make shoes, leather shoes and belts. Guys, you'll notice that this house right here, actually it's an example of how these houses are built. These are not stones, this is mud that is very strong. I don't know how it is, I didn't understand, but this is what they use. Then they plaster and then paint, and they are very, very strong. Actually very, very strong. If those houses have lasted for that long, it's very strong. Then you'll notice there are some other tourists. This guy right here,
is a tour guide guiding these people. You notice there are some vikapus, like some cultural artifacts that they're selling. And guys, right here we have a very old house. This used to be a police station very, very long ago. And the Fort Jesus by then used to act as a prison. And apparently it's no longer used. That's why it looks so unorganized and so, I don't know how to say it, but that's the way it looks. Then here, right here, we have the graveyard where Muslims bury dead Muslims. And guys, when you are dead as a Muslim, you're buried here. And then after some time, if another person dies, your bones are removed and another person is buried right there. And so this place is used, as you can see, it's also painted. Yeah, and that is how Old Town looks. Guys, you can see these woods right here. That is hardwood, and that's why I think some of these buildings have lasted for long, because they were built in a very strong manner. You can see this timber over here up, and I really appreciate this place. It's nice for me, but guys, oh my god, it's cool, but it's unsafe. We have a lot of thieves. It's unsafe actually even during the day. And so I decided to go to the beach to see how the view is on the other side. These are residents, so people live. And right here is the beach, guys. You notice that there's a building here, the building that I'm focusing on, and that's the English Point Marina. It's a very fancy hotel. It's a very, very nice for the tourist and for anyone who wants to go there. Right here, you notice there are people who are just breezing, and most of them are Muslim. Actually, they are not many, but they're Muslims. Yeah, then I just decided to talk to some people. Yeah, and guys, that comes to the end of my video. That's the Old Town review, as much as I didn't get to capture all the information. Yes. But at least that is a clear view of how Old Town looks.
And I actually said that I'll tell you why Old Town is unsafe even during the day. We have these young guys who will just come out of nowhere and pop with a knife and tell you, if you don't give me your phone, you'll have this. And no one will help you, by the way, because they fear that even them will be stabbed as you stabbed. So yeah, guys, they don't fear over here. So if you're new here, remember to subscribe, and for the returning subscribers, thank you so much, and may God bless you. And guys, see ya next time.